Hey, what's up, Grio fam? It's your girl, Shana Pinnock, social media director here at TheGrio.com, and this is Grio Top 3, powered by Dear Culture Podcast, where yours truly is a co-host alongside our managing editor, Jaren Keith Gaynor. But here on Grio Top 3, we give you the top 3 trending stories for the day. So let's get to it. Coming in at number 3, Leona Lewis calls out Michael Castello on Chrissy Teigen bullying accusations. It's apparently finger-pointing season in the celebrity world right now, with accusations of bullying coming from every direction. Unless you've been living under a rock, you've probably noticed that Chrissy Teigen, supermodel, TV personality, and wife of singer John Legend, has been in a bit of hot water these past couple of months for accusations of online bullying from her past. If you need a quick recap, it's believed Teigen once bullied a 16-year-old non-binary person, Courtney Stodden, on social media, going as far as to suggest that they commit suicide. There were also some unsavory 2013 tweets Teigen wrote about Beast of the Southern Wild child actress Quavonjene Wallace. These latest revelations have led to a slew of a loss of endorsements for Teigen, including being dropped by major retailers Bloomingdale's, Macy's, and Target that were selling or planning to sell Chrissy Teigen's cookware line. Earlier this week, 38-year-old fashion designer Michael Castello accused Teigen of bullying him in 2014 after a doctored Instagram comment made him appear to look racist. In a lengthy post to his Instagram account on Monday, June 14th, Castello says, quote, "For the past 7 years, I've lived with a deep, unhealed trauma. I wanted to kill myself, and I still am traumatized, depressed, and have thoughts of suicide." He went on to say that Teigen, quote, "apparently formed her own opinion of me based on a Photoshop comment floating around the internet. When I reached out to Chrissy Teigen to communicate that I was the victim of vindictive cyber slander and that everything she thought I was is not who I am, she told me that my career was over and that all my doors would be shut from there on." He then attached 2 screenshots of DMs allegedly between himself and Teigen. In the message, he asked Chrissy if he could call her. Her response, "No, I do not have anything to say to you. You will get what's coming to you." After he tells her, quote, "Chrissy, I've never called anyone the N-word. Those fake images were photoshopped from a former disgruntled employee." She allegedly replies, "Good luck with that, LMAO. Hope that story keeps your already dead career going." And some other pretty mean stuff. That same day, Chrissy Teigen issued her own lengthy statement via Instagram and in a Medium essay where she apologized extensively for her bullying past, even going so far as to call herself an internet troll. Teigen told her friends and followers, quote, "I know I've been quiet and Lord knows you don't want to hear about me, but I want you to know that I've been sitting in a hole of deserved global punishment. The ultimate, sit here and think about what you've done. Not a day, not a single moment has passed where I haven't felt the crushing weight of regret for the things I've said in the past. As you know, a bunch of my old awful tweets resurfaced. I'm truly ashamed of them. As I look at them and understand the hurt they caused, I have to stop and wonder, how could I have done that? There is simply no excuse for my past horrible tweets. My targets didn't deserve them. No one does. Many of them needed empathy, kindness, understanding, and support. Not my meanness masquerading as a kind of casual, edgy humor. I was a troll, full stop, and I am so sorry." Fast forward to yesterday, and UK singer Leona Lewis says Michael Castello exposing Chrissy for bullying is interesting, considering he bullied her in 2014 when she didn't fit into one of his dresses as she wasn't a quote-unquote model size. In her Instagram stories, because apparently all this airing out has to happen via iOS press release, Lewis says, quote, "I'm not discounting Michael's experience as that is an awful thing to go through and I wish him so much love and healing. I'm sure this will come as a shock as I never told him how this made me feel, but the pot calling the kettle black in this situation doesn't sit right with me. Bullying comes in many different forms. We need love, we need accountability, we need forgiveness. None of us are perfect." Castello has since responded to Lewis again via IG stories wondering how he bullied her when as recently as last month, Lewis and her team were friendly with him, requesting his styling, all the things. You can head to his Instagram page, his stories are still up there. All in all, I guess the only thing to say is don't be a jerk, don't be a bully, and don't be a troll. Now at number 2, Kevin Hart responds to backlash over cancel culture comments. Recently, while promoting his upcoming film, Fatherhood, with the Sunday Times, Kevin Hart shared his thoughts on cancel culture. The actor and comedian recalled the backlash he faced regarding past homophobic comments resurfacing in 2019, saying, quote, "If somebody has done something truly damaging, then absolutely a consequence should be attached. But when you just talk about nonsense, when you're talking, Someone said they need to be taken down. Shut the F up. What are you talking about? His comments left several social media users all up in their feelings, with many claiming that Hart is not as funny as he believes himself to be. Some even noted that, quote, the bigger he got, the more whitewashed his comedy got. Well, yesterday Kevin Hart had the time. He took to his Twitter account to address his critics, and in a series of tweets, Hart says, quote, I have three stand-up comedy specials that fall in the top 10 highest grossing comedy specials of all time. Two of my specials are in the top three of all time. I have been the highest grossing comedian in entertainment for years now. I have also been the highest grossing comedian in the box office with over $4 billion in earnings. I have also turned my comedic talent into a place of business and branding and radio and other revenue streams. The hate and slander fuels me to do more. Hart went on to note that he felt the need to address the critics and urged his fans to, quote, stop believing these headlines and read the actual articles. You guys fall for the banana in the tailpipe trick every damn time. In his final tweet, Hart says, quote, J. Cole said it best, if you're laughing at a millionaire, the joke's on you. Now back to your regularly scheduled program. Live, love, and laugh. So, it's interesting to note that in his Sunday Times interview, Hart stated, quote, when did we get to a point when life was supposed to be perfect? Where people were supposed to operate perfectly all the time? I don't understand. I don't expect perfection from my kids. I don't expect it from my wife, friends, employees. Because last I checked, the only way you grow up is from effing up. He went on to say, quote, I've been canceled, what, 3 or 4 times? Never bothered. If you allow it to have an effect on you, it will. Personally, that's not how I operate. Okay, now let's take a moment here, folks, and remember that if you've been canceled 3 or 4 times, you actually haven't ever been canceled. So how about we stop acting as though cancel culture is actually real? It isn't. Finally, at number one, judge dismisses charges against Simone Biles' brother. Ohio Judge Joan Sinenberg issued a ruling acquitting 26-year-old Teigen Biles Thomas, the brother of Olympic gymnastics champion Simone Biles. The murder charges against Biles Thomas were dismissed after the judge determined prosecutors did not present evidence to sustain a conviction in the 2018 New Year's Eve party shooting in Cleveland that left 3 men dead. Biles Thomas was accused of fatally shooting 19-year-old Delvonte Johnson and 21-year-old Tashawn Banks in an incident in which 23-year-old Devon Gibson, reportedly the cousin of Biles Thomas, was also shot to death. Biles Thomas was also acquitted of voluntary manslaughter and felonious assault charges, and his defense attorneys say there was no forensic evidence connecting their client to the killings and that no witnesses testified that they saw Biles Thomas shoot. In fact, Judge Sinenberg cited a witness for the prosecution who testified that she didn't see the shooter's face and was only about 75% certain that clothing seen on surveillance being worn by Biles Thomas matched her recollection of what the shooter was wearing. Biles Thomas, a U.S. Army soldier, has always maintained his innocence. In fact, his first trial ended in a mistrial last month after jurors said they had read legal paperwork that inadvertently was included in evidence given to them to review. Now, just in case you're wondering, Biles Thomas and Simone Biles were separated during childhood when their mother, who struggled with drug and alcohol dependency, lost custody of her 8 children. Biles and several siblings moved to Houston under the care of her paternal grandfather, while Biles Thomas was adopted by another relative in Cleveland. Simone Biles, to our recollection, has only commented on the case once in 2019 when she said, quote, my heart aches for everyone involved, especially for the victims and their families. There is nothing I can say that will heal anyone's pain, but I do want to express my sincere condolences to everyone affected by this terrible tragedy. We here at The Grio, our heart breaks for all of the victims and their families involved, and we certainly do hope that justice is served. Well, this has been Grio Top 3, powered by Dear Culture Podcast. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/TheGrio and the Dear Culture Podcast wherever you listen to podcasts. See you soon.